What's happening, everyone? It's Kyle from Magpie 24/7, and yeah, don't know if you've seen the news past couple of days, but mate Ashley's no longer owner of Newcastle United. Just soak it in, like what a fucking belter! Like I just can't believe it, like. 14 year, I didn't think it'd ever end. I thought, like, despite my optimism, I thought something would come up. I thought they pull the plug at the last minute, or but the other day, man, just absolutely insane. Like, checking Twitter literally every minute of the day at work, didn't get anything done. 4 o'clock finish, get myself to St James's Park, and what transpired after that? what an evening! Like, I've supported this club for a long time, and a lot of it is under the Mike Ashley regime. And with everything that's happened this season, with the toxicity around the club and fans attacking each other and all that, it just seemed to go away. And it was just. It was so beautiful just to see fans in the element. I was in my element, like just soaking it up, and the feeling, man. Like when it was announced at 5:15, it's a where were you moment when it happened, and just the utter. Just the utter relief. A new era has dawned on me, and I've got goosebumps as I say that, Ian. Like, it's just goosebumps. Like, we've got a new era. We're under new ownership. Mike Ashley's out the door. Mike Ashley's no longer a thing at Newcastle United. And from the videos I've seen on social media, the fans dancing and partying and singing through the night and everything. I like waited so long for this moment, man, as a fan. It's just I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. Like, the club are putting things out, like nice montages of the fans, and it's like the club gives a shit again. And then, like, Amanda Staveley's came in, she's done interviews, she speaks well, she's talking about Newcastle challenging for the fucking title, like, the title in 10 years, and like, Newcastle have become the richest club in the world. I feel like I'm in a dream, like, someone's gonna wake me up soon, and I'm gonna be like, right, that was a good dream, but we'll move on. But no one's woke us up yet, and it's kind of crazy, because we're talking about transfer windows being exciting. We're talking about managerial appointments. We're talking about a club ambitious again, full of hope and full of gravy and wanting to do something. Like, to be fair, if it was literally full of gravy, I don't think Steve Bruce would be going fucking anywhere, by the way. But, like, it's just unbelievable. Like, I kind of quite... get my head around it. It's insane. Like, waited so long, man. Like, to put it into perspective, I was 10 years old when Mike Ashley bought this football club. I'm 24 now, and like, I've seen some miserable times under that cunt. Like, I really cannot stand what he's done to this club. Sports Direct Arena, Joe Kinnear, Steve Bruce. Like, you could do a whole podcast on what he's done for this club. And try and summarise it, but at the end of the day, 2 relegations, just constant negativity among the fan base wanting more. But we've got that now. We've as the fans were chanting long into the night, we've got our club back. We've got our fucking club back. Like, it's borderline like emotional. Like, I'm absolutely buzzing of what the future could possibly hold for Newcastle United. Like, I'm looking forward to Tottenham. I cannot wait for the Tottenham game. I can't wait for every game now. Like, it's just unbelievable. Like, Amanda Staveley and her husband, I can't pronounce his name. Sorry about that, but they've came in, they've said the right things. They want to challenge. They want to overhaul everything about the club. And like, it's all right sitting here and saying, right, what do they need to do first? Obviously, sack Steve Bruce will be the first thing of many that they do at the football club. But I think regardless of what they do, they need support, which they've got unrivaled amount of support right now, and love and everything like that. They've got that, but they're going to need time. Like, I know a lot of fans are saying Mbappe, and I like, no. Realistically, we need to build this up. All the foundations need corrected, because at the end of the day, Amanda Staveley, Jamie Rubin, everyone in the consortium have got to unload 14 years of shit that Mike Ashley's plagued upon this club, and it's going to take a long time to do that. Obviously, there's rumours of them bringing Shearer back in an ambassadorial duty, Kevin Keegan. Like, they're doing the right things, but like, obviously, it's going to take time to get that right, and they're going to need time. They're going to need a good plan. And by the looks of things, they have coordinately planned this, and what they're doing and what they need to do. But it's, if anything, it's just a massive thank you to them. Amanda Staveley never gave up on this club. She never did. It's been going for 4 years now. I mean, Christ, in 4 years, I've been to uni. I've been on and left Newcastle Fans TV. I've done loads in 4 years, and she's concentrated on this club, like, insanely. Like, she's not slept until this deal was done. She's been mocked in the media by Mike Ashley, called a time waster. She's been mocked by many. By many a fan who thought they wouldn't be able to get the deal done. Like, she's never gave up on this club. She's wanted this club, and she's never gave up on it, and now she's got it. You can see the smile. You can see her taking time out of her day to speak to fans and cuddle fans, and it's so, like, it's unreal to see her. To see someone like Amanda Staveley come in and just want the best for this football club, and she's going to do everything she can, and she fought like mad to get here. So imagine what she's going to do to fight to get Newcastle at the top of the league. Perfect to have in charge of this football club. So just a massive thank you to Amanda Staveley. She's been relentless in her pursuit of this club, and now she's got it. I can only speak for me, but I'll back it at the very end, me. She's fought for this club. She's fought for us as a fan base. Now I'm gonna fight. Now we're gonna fight for her and take and try and take Newcastle at the top. With her, with the investment through PIF, and with the help of her husband, the Rubens brothers, take this club to the very top, man. It's just unreal. Like, my whole perception of Newcastle United's changed overnight. Like, there's hope again, there's faith again, there's everything again. Like, I can't wait to get amongst it. I can't wait to get watch games again and be excited. I can't wait to see what St James's Park's gonna be like on a match day, full every week. Like, it's sold out, it hasn't sold out in 3 years. Like, I can't wait to just see what it's going to be like. It's gonna be insane. I can't wait to see yous there as well. Like, get your comments in, man. Let us know how you feel. I feel absolutely over the moon with it. It's just like, I've been non-stop smiling for 3 days, winding every friend up who supports a different team. That we're coming for you, you bastards. But like, January, like, in terms of like breaking all this down, me and Paul are gonna do a podcast on it. The podcast is coming back, but it's not only coming back, but it's come back with a vengeance. Because, like, on a light note, away from all that, like, we've had messages from a lot of people that listen to the podcast asking how it's going and stuff. Because it was a once a month thing, but with everything going on, we've like waited and we've waited and waited and waited, and eventually, We thought we were going to record it Thursday, but obviously things were going like shit was hitting the fan. So now everything's the dust is settling, we know what's going on. We're going to do a podcast about it, and I can't fucking wait for this next podcast. Like, I've been itching to do a podcast for weeks now, and it's like, yeah, let's get amongst it. Finally, a positive podcast, finally, something positive to fucking talk about. A new era, a new dawn, a new Newcastle United. Thank fuck for that. It's been a long time coming, hasn't it? Paul, I know you're editing it, mate, so put that last in, put the old granny in. It's about fucking time. But it's been an emotional roller coaster under Mike Ashley, but from the bottom of my heart, mate, I can honestly say this to you, mate Ashley, it was not a pleasure. It just wasn't. You plagued my club for 14 years. The way you treated players, the way you treated fans, the total neglect in communication, the total neglect in appointing managers, the total neglect of the football club, it as a whole, the facilities, the players, everything. You got a couple of things right in your time here. But it was merely luck when you did. Like, the only time you give a shit was when we're in the Championship and you had to get back up to the Premier League for the money. Other than that, you could not give a fuck about this club. I don't want to hear your little statements about I've got the best interest in Newcastle United heart and I turned down bigger offers. At the end of the day, you're a snake and you were a leech at this football club, and it took someone special like Amanda Staveley to unleash you from this club. And it's a pleasure to see the back here. It's a pleasure to see the back of the likes of Lee Charnley, and hopefully it'll be the back end of the likes of Steve Bruce and people, little yes men that you had along the way, because the new Newcastle United is going to be based around a united front, and that's what Amanda Staveley says. Now, buying everything she says, because she fought to get you out of this club, just like the fans fought for such a long time to get you out of this club. So sayonara, and you will not be fucking missed. But yeah, get your comments in. Let us know how you feel. And yeah, can't wait for the podcast in a couple of days. Can't wait for this new Newcastle United and see how it goes from there. But new dawn, new era, new Newcastle United. See you there, everyone.